Good afternoon, students. Can you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everything yes, clear sir. Only, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, so up to submitting starts. Recording. So yesterday we have discussed up to velocity and also acceleration also we have defined, and we have seen the units of velocity and also speed. Now we will see the types of acceleration, very very important. This motion is mainly dependent on this acceleration only. If you understand acceleration only, you can able to understand the coming topics in motion. So here acceleration, I said that. So it is a vector quantity. I have defined acceleration as rate of change of velocity. Is called acceleration. Rate of change of velocity. So I can write A bar is equal to V bar minus U bar by time. So acceleration is a vector quantity, means the direction of acceleration, whichever direction velocity is acting, same direction acceleration. Direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity. So in whichever direction velocity is acting, in the same direction acceleration is going to act. Speed we can define only magnitude, but no definition, I mean sorry, but no direction. Whereas velocity, since the formula is given by displacement by time, so velocity, the direction of velocity is the direction of displacement. In the same way, the direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity. Change in velocity or velocity, both are same here. Here, already I told U means initial velocity. Always remember, initial velocity in physics is always denoted by small u. And final velocity means, suppose a body started from point A with 2 meters per second. After 1 minute, it has reached its velocity 10 meter by second. So final velocity means it is denoted by V. So the change in velocity means final velocity, V minus initial velocity U, that is called change. Rate of change means you have to divide the change in velocity with respect to time. Then we can say rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Now let us see the types of acceleration. Can you able to hear, ma? Just wave your hands. Understanding everything now? Right. Thank you. Now, types of acceleration. Types of acceleration. types of acceleration, very, very important concept, types of acceleration. First one, positive acceleration. Positive acceleration. Second one, negative acceleration. So there are two types of acceleration here, positive acceleration or negative acceleration. You see here, positive means you already know. So whenever I use positive means, we have to consider positive acceleration or acceleration, both are same. When I am not mentioning any acceleration means, suppose if you take a variable A, so then if I ask what is the symbol of A means, if anything is not mentioned, you have to consider it as positive. So acceleration, positive acceleration, both are same. Negative acceleration means that is different. Now let us see positive acceleration. Now let us see the positive. Board is not clear. Board is perfectly clear. Is my board is not clear? Just confirm. Those who are listening, clear now? Yes. Thank you. Board is clear. If the board is clear, my voice is breaking means the signal from your end, not my end. Right. So I will write the definition of positive acceleration. We can call it as positive acceleration, or simply we can call it as acceleration. Both are same only. As I said that, with respect to time, the velocity changes. With respect to time, the velocity is changing. Suppose the velocity is increasing with the time. So change in velocity means you can consider that velocity may decrease, velocity may increase. Whenever the velocity is increasing, whenever the velocity is increasing with respect to time, whenever the velocity is increasing, whenever the velocity is increasing, so increasing means positive acceleration, decreasing means negative. So you have to remember positive acceleration means always velocity is increasing. Negative acceleration means velocity is decreasing. That is the sign to remember positive and negative. Clear? Nod your heads, that's it. Clear now? Positive means, positive acceleration means you have to think in your brain. Velocity is increasing with respect to time. Negative acceleration means velocity is decreasing with respect to time. Now let me write the definition of positive acceleration or simply acceleration. Increase in velocity with respect to time. Is called positive acceleration. So increase in velocity, that means velocity is increasing with respect to time here. Velocity is increasing with respect to time. That means, suppose the body is initially started with velocity 2 meters per second. After some time, it became 7 meters per second. After 5 seconds, it has become. So according to the time, the velocity goes on increasing. That is called positive acceleration or simply acceleration. I will say one example. The train, suppose you know the train arrival and departure of time. So arrival, what train comes slowly and comes to rest. Departure means the train will leave from platform by picking up its speed. So with respect to time, when the train is leaving the platform, the speed or velocity goes on increasing. So I can write example, the train which is departing from the platform. Moving with increased velocity. Increasing velocity. So that means, so the train will come and stop. After it is leaving from platform, it slowly picks up the speed. That means its velocity speed. Why I am calling velocity means, if the train is moving in particular direction, I will talk about velocity. Speed means same. Speed has no direction. So a train which starts from platform, the train which starts from platform, starts from rest. So the train which starts from rest means immediately the train has stopped, and again it has, after the announcement, train will start its journey. When it is starting its journey, initially it will have less speed. After some time it picks up velocity. So the train which is starting from the rest is an example of positive acceleration. Why means? Because with respect to time, the velocity goes on increasing. This you have to remember. Is it clear, everybody? Just nod your heads. Clear now? Right. Then, one second. Shiva sir, light. Let me take the pic. Lights are coming. All right, yes. Now we will define negative acceleration. What is dull means here, the power is gone. That's why I have taken the windows. What is clear now? Now you can able to see now? Board. All right. Now let us see negative acceleration. Just opposite to positive acceleration, negative acceleration. Negative acceleration. So in the earlier we have seen positive means velocity is increasing with respect to time. Somebody is shouting, sir, when the train is slowly coming to platform is called negative SS. Thank you. You already know. Just listen. That's what I am going to say. Positive means increasing with respect to time. Negative means decreasing with respect to time. So, if the velocity of a body, decreases with respect to time, then the body
is moving with, the body is moving with negative acceleration. Negative acceleration. Body is moving with negative acceleration. You can also write decrease in velocity with respect to time. Is called negative acceleration. Decrease in velocity with respect to time is called negative acceleration. The other name for negative acceleration is negative acceleration. Is also called retardation or deceleration. So negative acceleration can be also called as with these two terms, deceleration and retardation. So retarding means you have to think that the body is moving with the negative velocity. Velocity is decreasing. Deceleration also, the velocity is deceleration. Now let us see the examples here. First one, as I informed earlier, the train which is starting from the platform, the train which is coming to the platform. So whenever the train is coming to the platform, what happens? The driver applies the brake. So when the driver applies the brake, the train gradually its velocity comes to rest. That means it is coming with in the decreasing in velocity. The train coming to the platform. You can also mention train coming to rest. So it's move with negative acceleration. Velocity goes on decreasing. So you can call this one as. And again, another example you can say, when we throw. When we throw any object upwards, its velocity goes on decreasing. At highest point, velocity becomes zero. So when you throw anything upwards, one second beyond the line, just write down. Maybe valana. Repista. Just be hold 1 minute. Thank you for being patient. Right. So, negative acceleration, positive acceleration. Just to remember one sign. When a train starts, when any object starts from rest, it is an example of positive acceleration. When any object comes to rest, it is nothing but board is not clear means everything is clear. Is my board not clear? Clear, no? My board. Please respond by waving. Clear, right. So this is positive and negative. Let me take the photograph. So we have seen acceleration, velocity, speed. Now, let us see. So from the speed, we will have uniform speed. Uniform speed, non-uniform speed, velocity, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration. These are very, very important. Now let us see first the types of speed. Types of speed. First one, uniform speed. So you already know that speed is defined as the ratio of distance to the time taken. So first you remember the formula. Speed is equal to distance by time. Now I will take one example here. A body is moving. From A to B, it travels 5 meters or 2 meters. 2 meters for 2 seconds. Again for 2 meters. Again it has traveled 4 meters, 4 seconds. 6 meters, 2 seconds. Like this, 8 meters, this is 6 seconds. 2, 4, 6, 8. So, for every 2 seconds, the object is moving 2 meters. Again, 2 meters increase for 4 seconds. Like this, you can see equal changes in distances in equal intervals of time. So the body is moving equal distances. Board is not clear. That is your network problem. I can't do anything. Board is clear only. So uniform means constant. I will define now. Same, if a body is making equal distances in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be moving with uniform speed. Uniform means constant speed. If a body is moving with equal distances in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be moving with uniform speed. So if a body is moving with equal distances in equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be moving with uniform speed. Now I will take here, suppose distance, time.
If the time is zero, distance is also zero. The time is 2, the distance is 2 meters for every 2 seconds. 4 seconds, again the distance increased 4 meters. 6 seconds, again the distance is increased 6 meters. That means for every 2 seconds, the distance is increasing. Distance is increasing by 2 meters for every 2 seconds. So this is the data, distance and time. Now if you want to draw the, so there is a graph is there, you can draw the these values, you can draw these values on the graph. I think you know graph. So x-axis, y-axis, you already know. So if I take, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is called origin. In your mathematics, you know. Always remember, when you are drawing graphs, especially in motion, we can call it as a distance-time graph. Distance-time graph. Distance-time. Distance means S. Hyphen time means T. Now you see here, for zero time, so always remember, independent variable should be taken on x-axis. Time I have to take on x-axis. Distance varies, no? Distance is taken on y-axis. Always remember, you should not be confused. On x-axis, always you have to take time. Independent variable, that means time won't depend on anything. That's why we have to take on x-axis. But distance depends on time. Then, which is dependent variable, that should be taken on y-axis. Now you see here for 2 meters. So t means 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds, 6 seconds. Here 1 meter, 2 meters, 3 meters, 4 meters, 5 meters, 6 meters. So you have to mention the scale here on x-axis. X-axis, 1 unit is equal to 1 second. The distance between 1 unit is equal to 1 second. On y-axis, we can call it a scale. Compulsory, you need to measure scale. You need to mention scale means on x-axis, 1 unit is equal to how much? On y-axis, 1 unit is equal to how much? X-axis, 1 unit. Y-axis, 1 unit is equal to, so there is a distance of 1 meter. Now, for 2 seconds, the distance traveled. So here you have to point. So 2 seconds, the distance traveled is 2 meters. For 4 seconds, the distance traveled is 4 meters. So here 1 point. For 6 seconds, the distance traveled is here. So you got a point. You just join this line. Join these points. So when you join these points, you are going to get one straight line passing through the origin. That means uniform, the shape of the graph of a uniform speed is, it is a straight line which is passing through the origin. Origin means this one. The point where the x-axis and y-axis intersect each other. So this is an example of uniform speed. Uniform speed means a body which is moving with equal distances in equal intervals of time. This is called uniform speed. So the shape of the graph of a uniform speed is, it is a straight line which is passing through the origin. Now we will have doubt section. Is it clear, ma?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubts,
sir, can we leave, sir?
Yes, sir.
No doubt, sir.
No doubt, sir.
Tell me if you have any, if you interact with me, you know.
No, sir. No doubt, sir.
Sir, please continue the class, sir.
we leave, sir?
Sir,
what this mask?
There will be
no doubt, sir.
Is clear. You are you,
no doubt, sir.
Sir,
sir, we want
sir.
Right running now, sir.
No, no
sir.
Doubt that.
Mute them, sir. One second, ma.
So can I say something?
Small announcement. So the motion, the fundamental subjects, right from the motion up to here, wherever I thought. So you have to give seminar. You have to give seminar because yourself. And you need to send to my WhatsApp by Saturday evening or by Sunday evening. You have to mention your branch and you have to mention your class also. Branch and class. The topic is on motion. You can select any topic, whatever I have thought. Just 5 to 15 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes enough or 15 minutes maximum. You can select any topic and you have to use on motion. On Monday, I am going to announce the winner. You take any topic. So this is the, you can utilize this opportunity because it will be a refreshing thought for you. If you are able to say whatever you have learned in words, especially communication skills will be improved. So everybody, I expect everybody will compulsory, whether win or lose, doesn't matter. If you participate, that will really increase your conference skills and communication skills also. Just 10 to 15 minutes topic you take, you can take the help of paper or board, anything. Just 10 to 15 minutes and send that video. Monday, I am going to announce the winner. Submit. Then, say your doubts.
Sir, negative adjustment.
Sir, next class onwards, sir.
Best position,
sir. Class is finished, sir.
Sir.
Don't talk all at a time.
Sir.
Class finished.
Sir, negative acceleration means the object which comes to rest position, sir.
No. The object with which the velocity goes on decreasing, not rest position. Tell me any doubt.
Sir, do we need to use paper outside any compulsory, sir?
You can take the help of chart.
Sir, can we say definition, sir? Is it compulsory, sir?
Sir, class is finished, sir.
I can ask this is doubt session. Last 10 minutes.
Sir, can we say definition, sir?
One at a time. You can leave.
Sir, can you say definition, sir?
You can say anything. That is your wish.
Okay, sir.
You have to explain. You have to explain very effectively.
Sir.
Whichever seminar I feel good, that I am going to forward to our managing director. Tell me any doubts.
Sir, on which topic, sir?
Sir, which principle we have?
Motion.
We can select any topic.
Right,
sir.
From the definition, start, rest, motion.
Sir, only physics only, sir.
From there on, also distance. Physics only. My topic is physics. Why are you asking like that?
About what?
You can select any topic, motion.
Any topic about motion, sir?
Motion. Any topic.
Okay, sir.
Then we have to end, sir.
Once you switch on your cameras, you ask me. Switch on your cameras.
So you should send to whom, sir? You are your principal.
To my only, to my WhatsApp number. You can see my WhatsApp number, no?
Yes, sir.
Tell me any doubt you are having.
You can
explain in any way you want. Explain.
Okay, sir.
Subject should be clear.
Can we add more matters, sir?
Can
we add more matters?
You can do in chat, sir.
Whatever you want, you do, but it should be effective. It should be very lively and
time duration, sir.
We have to tell our.
We can do in chat, sir.
But don't by heart and say. Sir,
can you share one topic, sir? About
motion. Okay, sir.
You can take any topic in motion.
Say one topic.
So what is the maximum time duration, sir?
10 to 15 minutes enough.
Okay.
10 to 15 minutes. Enough. 10 to 15 minutes enough.
Okay, sir.
Any doubts?
Can we leave, sir?
Who is this? Danu to everyone. Tell any topic. Tell any topic means you take important definitions in motion. Distance, displacement, speed, velocity. You can take even, you can take the types of speeds also. Uniform speed or types of acceleration also.
Have to send that numbers.
3.
When we are going to send the video for you.
Sir, someone doing over action, sir.
Over action. Sunday evening you send, ma. Sunday evening.
Okay, sir.
To my WhatsApp number.
Okay, sir. Send your bird pics, sir.
Tell me. I will send this pics. You just WhatsApp me.
Yesterday also not keep the boating.
Some people are singing
songs. Musko.
Sir, send
book. I am going to send.